Designing your own portfolio can be stressful, challenging, and time-consuming, but the final result is really rewarding. Hi everyone, in this video, I'm going to explain how I designed and built my portfolio from scratch. First, let's talk about the investment. Making a portfolio website has several investments apart from time. Any no-code tool can cost up to $200 per year. Also, there are a few other investments like getting your portraits done by a photographer, hiring a content writer, or proofreading. Last two are not that necessary, but if you are investing your time in making your portfolio, then it's kind of become important. So I didn't rush myself while creating this website. I worked mostly 2 to 3 days a week. It took an overall of 3 months to complete the entire project. 2.5 months was required for designing and took me around 3 to 4 days for entire development. There was no coding involved. But if you just want to pause everything and just focus on your portfolio, it might take you like a week or two or less than that. On this note, I would now talk about how I develop my portfolio and the checklist that I've created for myself while doing the same. These steps I believe will help you understand how I approach this project. Irrespective of how you want to build your portfolio, this steps should be applicable to all. First, we need to understand why we need a portfolio website. Behance and Dribbble are brilliant tools that can be used to create and showcase your work. I have used Behance for the first 5 years of my design career, and it has in fact served me better than any other design tool. Then you should be asking why we create a personal website. There are two main reasons. First was, I wanted to create a self-governing platform where I could be completely free of platform constraint. While Behance, Dribbble, or Instagram are great platforms, but there are a lot of rules and regulations that one has to follow for publishing their work. For instance, Behance always requires one to create a case study, and Dribbble only accepts the short form of content. Second, I also wanted to have a place where I could put forth myself as a designer and an artist and share my entire journey. Storytelling was my main intention. I wanted people visiting my portfolio to know me a little better and judge my work accordingly. Third is one of the most important reasons why I think you should consider building your portfolio. So I'm making this video in January 2023 and we are in the middle of recession. At this point of time, a lot of big tech companies have laid off their employees. And so what happens during this layoff is, once they decide to lay off an employee, they generally take off their email access. And once they take off their email access, you actually lose access to your Figma. So a lot of designers we know, they just lost their Figma access when company decided to let them off. And as a result, what happened was designer lost the access of Figma and they didn't even get a chance to take a backup of their work. I understand a lot of companies have a lot of privacy rules regarding downloading anything from Figma, but you can always choose to make a case study and put it on your portfolio. This is a sad reality, but this is what it is. So do make all your case studies and publish your portfolio. I think that would help a lot. This brings me to my next point, which is the most time consuming process in the entire portfolio, is to make your case studies. Choose around 3 to 5 work depending on your years of experience and create case studies. Just make your case studies and keep them as a backup. This is the first step of actually creating a portfolio. Now let's start designing the website. It actually starts from deciding on the information I wanted to put on my portfolio, like home, about me, work, blog. Followed by that is the second step, which is designing the IA and the navigation of the website. Once I did my IA, I started with the research. I have a good collection of graphic design books, movies. Also, I did take a lot of inspiration from the movies, like the barcode you see on the pre-order was actually taken from the movie Hitman. The dog that you find on my 404 page was inspired from the episode 1 where Chandler doesn't like dogs in Friends. The telephone animation on the contact page replicates physical telephone. The fingerprint in the work page represents authenticity and so on. Till now, if you have seen this video, please do subscribe to my channel. Since I've just started YouTube, this will help me to grow the channel. When I was done with my IA and I knew what I wanted to do in my portfolio, I moved to the visual design stage. For me, typography is 90% of design. Choosing a typeface is a whole different science, but the basic concept is to have a similar line height. For my portfolio, I chose Inter and Libra Castellon text, and I've used only 3 fonts in total from both the typeface. So this is 101 of graphic design. If you want to keep your design clean, try to limit the number of font you are using on your portfolio. For colors, I chose to go with neutral colors since I wanted to absolutely focus on the work that I'm presenting. And most of my work have colors in them, so I didn't want any conflicting colors in my website. For iconography, I wanted to design icons that work seamlessly with the typography, and this is what I came up with. In terms of tools, I have used Figma for design. For animation, I have used After Effects and later used Lottie files to import those on the website. When design was done, I did send the design to my design mentor for feedback. This was an important part for building the portfolio website, since I wanted to understand how my portfolio was perceived by a very senior designer. Because at the end of the day, a design manager or client is the one who is going to hire me, so their perspective kind of became very important for me. That brings me to my next point, content and photography. A crucial part here is content strategy, and you should definitely invest time and money into it. When I made my portfolio, I wanted to focus a lot on the storytelling part. I wanted to tell people from where I come from, what made me a designer, and not just showing the normal work that I have. If that's something you wanted to do, please do think about what you want to show on your portfolio and then decide on the content strategy. Remember, at the end of the day, your portfolio will reflect who you are as a person, and clients or companies actually hire you and not just your design skills. For content, I actually hired a writer for the proofreading. The next part is actually getting your portrait done. So you can choose to go to a professional photographer, but you can also choose to like put your selfie or something. That's absolutely up to you, whatever you feel comfortable with. After the design was done, I prepared my file for development. I used Webflow for my website, but feel free to use any other service you like. I kind of found Webflow to be the best option for me because of its CMS and integration with Lottie files. It kind of helped me to export and animations. If you guys are using Webflow, please do sign up from the link given in the description. It's an affiliate link, but absolutely no pressure. Development has few other steps like uploading the actual content, writing the alt text, setting up your fab, WebP icons, and redirects. If you guys are new to Webflow and wanted some tutorials on how to make your portfolio, please do let me know in the comments. I can make some tutorial videos on those. Now that all the work was done, the only thing left for me was to ship it. So you should be able to see the complete checklist on the screen, and also I've mentioned it on the video description and also on this blog on my website. I hope you have fun building your portfolio. Please let me know in the comments what kind of challenges you are facing on designing or building your portfolio. Please do like, share, and subscribe, and thank you so much for watching this video.